We should come back to this another time.
Shall we?
You were able to take care of everything.
Professor, I completed all of your most recent assignments.
Well done. Then you're ready to learn Expelliarmus. Pay close attention. The disarming charm may often be all you need to defeat the most powerful dark witches and wizards you might encounter. Spellcasting requires a focused mind and a steady wand. You wish to stay in practice.
Expelliarmus!
You seem to have the right end of the stick. But keep practicing. Expelliarmus may save your life one day.
Rebellion. Revelio. 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 Incendio! Levioso! Revelio! Revelio!
Aha, got it.
Revelio. 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 Incendio. Levioso. Accio. Incendio. Expelliarmus. Revelio. 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 Let me also. Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Now, artists, let us begin.
Revelio.
Leviosa! Instantly. Expelliarmus!
Revelio. Revelio.
Lumos.
Revelio. 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 Revelio.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
We meet again, Richard Jackdaw.
I suppose I shouldn't be surprised to see you. Just like a Gryffindor to brave the Forbidden Forest in pursuit of adventure.
Well said. Now where do we go from here?
Follow me. I shall lead you as far as I can, but I fear I may remain a tad reluctant to revisit the scene of my demise. Keep your eyes open for a birdbath. When you find it, say intramuros. I think it's Latin. Or Greek. As you can imagine, I never paid much attention in school. Shall we?
Aside from the bird bath, anything else I should look for?
Indeed. A few landmarks, a stone bridge, a waterfall, and, if I recall, a lake. You'll see.
You've been very helpful. Thank you.
Surprising how much of this is rather unfortunately coming back to me. Yes. You know, the closer we get, the more I'm remembering. Probably best I leave you to it. Simply stick to the path and keep a sharp eye out for that birdbath. Adieu.
Is that Latin?
Or Greek?
Surprisingly as good as his word.
Revelio.
Something oddly solemn about this place. Such regal creatures, stags. There it is, just as Jackdaw described. Intramuros.
Aren't you a little far from home?
Renrock knew you'd eventually lead us to whatever it is you're hiding.
Let me open. Accio.
No risk those loyalists will report back to Ranrok now. Let's see where Jackdaw has led me. I wonder how big this place is.
Revelio.
These rooms must have something to do with opening this door. Impressive. That must be where all this leads. Someone didn't want casual visitors down here.
Revelio.
I wonder if any of my spells will help me through this.
Incendio! Expelliarmus! Accio! I'm not going to touch those. Revelio. Revelio.
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
It's a good thing Jackdaw didn't fall down there.
Revelio.
I'm glad Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind for me, but where could he be?
Accio! Revelio. Expelliarmus. Incendio. Accio. Levioso! Potato! Revelio! Incendio! Reparo! Revelio. Accio. Revelio. Accio.
Not a headless skeleton in sight. But I may as well help myself with this.
Revelio. Huh? Accio! Levioso! Expelliarmus!
Incendio!
Lumos!
An untouched chest. Terrador wasn't very thorough in his search of this cave.
Incendio! Accio!
I'm glad Richard Jackdaw left a little something.
Revelio. Accio.
Protego!
Lumos.
Huh.
spiders. These can't be what the hell is the Jajang.
Accio. Revelio.
Farewell, monster. I can only imagine how these spiders have multiplied since Jackdaw came this way.
Revelio.
To look around for the symbol.
Revelio.
Jackdaw would have been interested in this loot, but there's no sign of him.
Incendio! Revelio.
We meet again, Richard Jackdaw. Thank you for keeping these pages safe all these years. Here it is. The map that brought your doom, Jackdaw. Is there something beyond this room?
Protego! Expelliarmus! Expelliarmus! Expelliarmus.
What? That's unnerving. What's happening? I've seen this before. In Gringotts and the restricted section.
Rebellion.
Where am I?
Oh no, the room's starting to flood. How am I being protected? What sort of magic is this?
I can only hope this magic protects me until I'm able to make my way out of here.
What is this place?
Rebellion.
Can it be?
It's you.
Has someone finally found our map chamber?
I recognize you from the Pensives. You're Professor Rackham.
I am indeed. I must confess that I am surprised to see someone so young standing before me.
I'm the same age that you and Isadora Morganarch were when you started at Hogwarts.
You've paid attention, and might I presume you share our ability?
To see traces of ancient magic? Yes, sir, I do.
As you have likely realized by now, our ability gives us a unique relationship with all forms of magic. We can access expressions of magic that few others can. Opportunities will arise that allow you to sharpen this rare talent. Do not squander them.
I won't, Professor. Thank you.
We have much to discuss. But first, a map found in a certain book led you here. Place the book on the pedestal.
I don't have the book with me, sir.
That is unfortunate. I'm afraid we must pause our conversation until you return with the book.
I'm a bit confused, sir.
Why is this room called the map chamber?
I assure you that all will be clear once the book has been placed on the pedestal.
Very well. I'll retrieve the book right away.
Good. We shall speak again once the book is in place.
Incendio!
I found the pages and the map chamber. Why would I need the book?
Revelio. Revelio.
I'm back at Hogwarts. I wonder when Professor Fig will be back. I did promise him I wouldn't neglect my studies while he was away. Suppose I have enough to distract myself with doing the return of the book.
Revelio. 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 Accio. Revelio. Incendio. Revelio. 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 Revelio.
Lumos.
Incendio.
Lumos.
Incendio.
Lumos.
Incendio.
Lumos.
Revelio.
Lumos.
Revelio.
Lumos.
Incendio. Revelio. Incendio. Incendio.
Lumos.
Protego.
Lumos. Lumos.
Incendio.
Accio. Lumos.
Incendio. Revelio. Revelio. Incendio.
Lumos.
Incendio.
Lumos.
Revelio.
Everybody grab a broom, and we shall get started. Mr. Clothen, your attention, please.
Sorry, Madam Kagawa.
Everyone, please welcome a new student to our flying class. The goal of today is to remind all of you how to maneuver on a broomstick safely.
Hello.
As broom flight is, first and foremost, a means of transportation.
This, I fear, some of you have forgotten.
Diving, rolling, and loop-the-loops will not be taught or in fact tolerated in this class. We'll leave that to professional Quidditch players, like the Toyohashi Tengu.
Boo.
Not a fan, I take it?
Now,
Let's see how well everyone kept up with their practice over the summer holidays. For those who need a refresher, step up to your broom. Say up firmly and clearly. Then kick your leg over and rest your weight on the seat. Up!
Thank you.
Now, your turn.
Up!
Up!
Up, you stupid ratty school broom!
Up!
One leg over, so there's a leg on each side. None of that side saddle nonsense. A gust of wind will throw you right off. And if you hear my whistle while you're in flight, ground yourself at once. Well done. Now that you're acclimatized to your broom, let's see how well you manage with a more advanced exercise, shall we? This next set of rings will take you around the grounds for more of a challenge.
Hello! Nice day!
Our aquatic resident likes to make an appearance once in a while. I say, I watched you fly through those rings. You seem to handle yourself on that dusty school broom well enough. I'd imagine you're ready for something a bit more challenging. But I'm getting ahead of myself. We haven't properly met. I'm Everett Clopton. Am I right in suspecting that a Gryffindor like you might be interested in a high-flying adventure?
Can't say no to that. What did you have in mind?
A bit of a detour, so to speak. Follow me. The tour is about to begin. Follow closely now.
Now that's more like it!
You sure you're not part Hippogriff?
Tips and a jaunt around Hogwarts. This is quite the tour, Everett.
Dismount here.
And where have you two been?
Oh, hello, Professor. We were trying to get a bit of extra practice in.
Hefty points will be taken from each of you for not following my instructions. Mr. Clopton, I'm disappointed in you. You're in this class because you're still not showing yourself, or frankly, your broom, the proper respect.
But, Professor...
Enough. Class is finished for the day. As for you, you do well to use better judgment in the future. Chin up. That was some rather good flying.
Sorry about that business with Kagawa, but you have to admit, those views were worth it.
It was worth losing a few house points for that detour.
You seem at home on a broom. Bet if you had a fancy model, you could fly laps around Imelda. She's Kagawa's favorite. I could show her a thing or two if I had my own broom. Hate having to return the school broom after class.
Perhaps I'll have to purchase a broom then.
If you can, you should. Wish I could. I recommend visiting Albie Weeks at Spintwitch's in Hogsmeade. He's always looking to test new models. I'll keep an eye out for you in the sky.
Ah, new face. Wonderful.
Hello, Mr. Weeks, is it?
Albie Weeks at your service. Welcome to Spint Witches. Apologies if you came by before and weren't able to come in. Shop's been closed since trade routes were disrupted. Had to travel as far as London to meet with my supplier. And I've only just returned, thankfully with inventory. I presume you're in the market for a new broom? Got a few rare yew weavers available. Ember Dash, Silver Arrows, Wind Wisps too. No matter what broom you choose, you'll be pleased. They're all exceptional, both in quality and performance.
Sounds quite the array of brooms. I'll have a look around. Thank you.
What are we looking for today? Nice doing business with you. You'll be thrilled with that broom, I promise you. Whilst nearly any broom will certainly be a step up from the practice brooms in Kagawa's class, they all have their limitations. You seem to be a flyer who might be interested in, say, some enhancements.
Go on.
Ha! Knew I was right about you. I think you'll be quite happy with the performance of any broom at lower altitudes. But you may notice that speed consistency tends to falter as you rise. I believe I can remedy this issue. I have some ideas for enchantments, upgrades, if you will, that will improve the performance of any broom you fly. What I need is someone to conduct a broom flight and report back to me so I can perfect the upgrades. As it happens, another Hogwarts student, Imelda Reyes, is using abandoned broom courses for time trials. Clever girl. An ideal situation for collecting flight statistics. If you were to compete for the best time and succeed, then report back to me with how your broom behaved, I could complete work on my first upgrade. What say?
That sounds intriguing. I'll see what I can do.
Thank you. It'll be worth your while. If I'm right, the new upgrade ought to enhance brooms in every regard. And I can give you a special price. The time trial should be a bit of fun too. Go to the Quidditch pitch and Imelda Reyes will sort you out. Once you've beaten Imelda's time, be sure to let me know.
And they have a nice view from up there.
Hey you, Gryffindor.
Imelda Reyes? Albie Week sent me.
Did he now? Still tinkering with his broom upgrade, no doubt. I tried to help him once. He nitpicked my flying technique, and that was the end of that. The nerve. Why is he roping you into his broom testing silliness? You've barely started flying from what I know. Caught wind of you showing off in flying class with Clopton.
Seems someone's jealous of my skills on a broom.
Me? Slytherin Quidditch captain? Jealous of you?
Everyone knows that class is only for beginners, troublemakers, and bumbling baboons. But for some reason, now people think you're competition. Ugh, I can't be having that.
Perhaps I am competition.
You're not even Slytherin. Could be a useless squib for all I know. Enough of this.
Only one way to find out who's the better flyer. I hold one of the fastest times on this course.
Let's see if you can beat it. Slytherin versus Gryffindor.
Actually, why not? I can beat your record.
I'm so looking forward to seeing you lose.
This is rather fun. Made it! Oh, did anyone else see that?
Ugh, that's not... You must have cheated, you... Ugh. Fine, you won. Don't think this is over. You can't determine skill from one single trial.
Surely my win means something.
You're not terrible, but you're still going to have to prove yourself if you want to earn my respect.
Challenge accepted, then.
Perhaps you have what it takes after all. We shall see. But don't get your hopes up. The next course near Irondale offers a much tougher challenge. You can try to prepare by racing this course again. Just check in at the podium, where the leaderboard is. You can check your time and start the race. We'll see next time if your win here was more than just a fluke, whilst on an errand for Albie Weeks.
I suspect Mr. Weeks will be glad to hear how I fared.
Oh, you're back! With something to report, I hope?
Mr. Weeks, I was able to set a record on my broom.
Incredible! Miss Reyes must have been shocked. Tell me, how was the broom?
A little turbulent and it's wanting for a bit of speed, but it fared well enough. I will say that it tended to drift a bit to the left on certain turns. Heard a slight swoosh when I dipped.
Oh, thank you. That's precisely what I needed to know. Drifted, eh? I shall get to work immediately. Even the naysayers will be forced to admit that my works had potential all along.
Why would anyone doubt your ability to upgrade brooms?
Oh, you'd be surprised. People get set in their ways, worry that fiddling with what's working fine will somehow ruin it. Those people don't appreciate the sense of freedom that comes with quality broom flight, nor do they appreciate all that's involved in the creative process. I have a friend in Rome, runs a shop like mine, says it's worse there. Of course, they do nap in the afternoons from what I hear. And where would we be without enhancements? I mean, if Elliot Smevic had let the naysayers get to him, we would never have had the cushioning charm. I don't listen to him.
I'm excited to hear more.
I have a very good feeling about this upgrade. I guarantee you'll be pleased. Expect to hear from me soon.
Revelio. To address the issue of altitude as it relates to speed.
Lumos.
Hello there. In the market for potions, are we? What can I do for you today? Hope to see you again. Farewell for now.
Hello, Mr. Pippin. You need help with a delivery?
Yes, I do. A capable student such as yourself should have no trouble making the trip to Cambridge. It's just south of Hogwarts.
What do you need delivered?
Fatima Lawang ordered a few invisibility potions. I used to go myself, but lately Fatima has taken to turning every visit into an argument. Constantly complaining about the quality of my stock. But how can I maintain excellence which you order so often, giving me no time to brew? If you take this rather irritating task off my hands, I'd happily allow you to claim the delivery fee from Fatima.
I'd be happy to help with the delivery.
You've no idea how grateful I am, truly. Here are the invisibility potions she requested. Hopefully she won't give you too much trouble. She's a talented potioner in her own right. I dare say I wouldn't mind having a look at her potion recipes one day.
Revelio.
Lumos.
Revelio.
Levioso.
Accio. Incendio.
Levioso.
Accio.
Incendio. Revelio. Levioso,
Accio.
Incendio.
Levioso,
Accio.
Incendio. Revelio.
Protego.
Levioso.
Accio.
Levioso.
Accio.
Incendio.
Not my fault you're a deadly great spider. Let's see what's up your sleeve this time, Merlin.
Levioso.
Accio.
Incendio.
Expelliarmus.
Lumos.
Reparo.
Levioso.
Always make that.
That Pippin should have been here by now.
Madam Luang, I have a delivery from J. Pippin's potions.
Sent a child to do his work for him, did he? Always cutting corners and taking the easy way out. Did he have you brew them for him as well? Doesn't matter. You could probably do it better than he can anyway.
Here are the potions you requested.
You think it's so simple? I know Pippin is always trying to cheat his customers. Cutting corners to save some galleons for himself at the expense of quality. You'll not be getting a canut out of me until you prove the potion works. Drink it.
I'd rather not, but if you insist, so be it.
I do insist.
Nice to see you again.
Likewise. What can I help you with today?
What do you have for sale?
What are we looking for today? This will do just fine. Thank you for stopping in.
Nice to see you again.
Likewise. What can I help you with today?
What do you have for sale?
What are we looking for today? Thank you for stopping in. I appreciate it.
Incendio.
Expelliarmus!
It seems to have worked.
Well, I suppose that will do.
If the demand for potions is as high as you say, have you considered being easier to work with? Perhaps combining your recipes and skills?
Ha! Not a chance. That ne'er-do-well had his shop handed to him. The rest of us had to make our own way. I'll not give him the benefit of my hard work and gumption. If he fails on his own, so be it.
You mentioned that more and more customers are trying to stay out of sight. Why?
Well, I can't speak for all of them, but certainly my Ashwinder customers have their reasons. If I were you, I'd forget I heard that.
Very well. I shall let Mr. Pippin know I delivered the potions as requested.
You do that.
I should be going now. Thank you.
Protego!
Hogsmeade, here I come.
Revelio.
Come on in. Healing potions are a speciality here, should you need any.
I delivered the potions to Fatima Luang.
Very good. And did she cause you any trouble?
I can see why you didn't want to go. She was quite cantankerous.
I do truly appreciate your help. And at least it's done with.
Delivering those potions was a bit more work than I'd expected. I'd like an additional fee.
I suppose that's business for you. Very well, I shall increase your pay, but I'm not at all pleased about it.
Best of luck with your potions, Mr. Pippin.
Do take care.
Rebellion.
I wonder where they go.
Pardon me, but were you saying something?
Oh, hello. Talking to myself. I'm Clementine Willardsey, charmed. I was musing on the precious butterflies I see near the edge of the forest. Whenever I come near, they fly off into it. When I was at Hogwarts, we truly were forbidden from entering the forest. Told horrible stories about it, and I've had an irrationally intense fear of it ever since. It's silly, but I'm insatiably curious as to where the butterflies go in the forest. You couldn't possibly find out, could you?
You want me to follow the butterflies?
I do, yes, if you wouldn't mind.
What were the horrible stories you were told about the Forbidden Forest?
Oh, goodness, everything from students being mysteriously beheaded to terrifying spider dens. Oh, trust me, you hear that at 11 years old. It sticks with you.
Very well. If I have time, I shall see where they lead.
Oh, how kind. Students these days have so much more courage than I ever did. You can usually find me right around here. I hope to see you soon. Don't forget, the butterflies always seem to be on the fringes of the Forbidden Forest. Good luck!
There they are. She wasn't making it up. Well, we've come this far. Miss Willardsey might get an answer about these butterflies.
Folks still talk about you taking down that troll in the village circle. You certainly made an impression.
Oh, please! You have an answer for me about the butterflies.
Hello, Miss Willardsey.
Well, what happened? Did you find them?
They led me into the forest and revealed a treasure.
Oh, how lovely! I'm glad you were rewarded for your efforts. Perhaps one day I'll be able to bring myself to go into the forest. For now, I'm happy simply knowing there's something so lovely to see. Should I dare?